Okay, so what we're gonna do today is we're gonna talk about a concept called optimization. Optimization is using the idea of extrema, finding relative or local maximums or minimums, to solve real world problems, meaning we're gonna try to maximize or minimize, optimize certain things. So if I was gonna build a deck, I wouldn't wanna buy too much material because then I'd waste money. I don't wanna spend or buy too little material because then I wouldn't be able to finish my deck. I want to optimize my checking account and my paychecks so that I can afford what I need and do exactly what I'm looking for. I want to get from one place to another without wasting gas. So I don't want to spend too much money on gas. I want to be able to make sure I get just the right amount. If I'm trying to feed or, let's say, pay employees, what would be the greatest equation or best way to maximize my profits but minimize my costs? I don't want to have to overspend my employees and never make anything from it. Or what happens if I'm spending for food? I want to buy food for a party. Well, I don't want to overbuy and have all this wasted food, and I definitely don't want to underbuy because then I wouldn't be a good host and we wouldn't have enough food for the party. So what we're going to look at is the idea that we tend to figure out the ideas of optimization, maximums and minimums, just in real world life, and how that we can use calculus to find the same things. So the first thing that we're going to talk about is the steps. There are some pretty cookie cutter steps on how to do optimization. So it's not like related rates. Related rates, we were changing with respect to time, and it varied depending on the type of question we had. Optimization is a lot more straightforward. There's really just three steps that we've got to follow for any time we're going to optimize or max and min some kind of question. So here are the three steps. One, we need to get two equations. So somewhere within the problem, we gotta find two equations. Then step two, we're gonna plug one of those equations into the other and we're gonna simplify it. And then step three, we're gonna take the derivative of this new equation we just found in step two and set it equal to zero and solve. That's it. That's all we ever have to do for optimization. So once again, we take these two equations that we find from our problem. We're gonna take one of them and plug it into the other, take a derivative and set it equal to zero, solve. That's as hard as optimization is. So the biggest part that we need to spend most of our time on, what are the two equations? So let's start with a really basic question and then we can build from there. So the first question that we have is the product is 192 and the sum is a minimum. Not a very difficult question, but it's the building blocks and what we're going to see and how we're gonna use it. So somehow we have to come up with two equations from this one sentence. So it says, the product is 192. So let's stop right there. The product is 192. Well, we know is means equals. Product means two things are being multiplied. So that means two things being multiplied together is going to equal 192. Well, we get to choose what those two variables are. We tend to use X and Y, but if you like some other letter, go for it. So the product is 192. We'll say X times Y equals 192. That's our first equation. Now let's see what the second equation says. Second part of the equation is going to say, and the sum is a minimum. The sum is a minimum. Well, there's a second part that we need to look at. The sum. Sum means two things being added together. What two things? We already chose X and Y to be our two variables, so why don't we stick with that? So the sum, let's go X plus Y, is once again, is equals. So the sum is a minimum. Well, we don't really know what this means, but we know didn't tell us it equaled 192. We don't know what this is, so we can say M for minimum, we can say S for sum, it depends on what you want. So it doesn't really matter. We can say X plus Y equals S or X plus Y equals M. I'm gonna choose M because sometimes my S's look like fives and I don't want it to get confused. So what did we do? Step one, we read our sentence and we found two equations. The product is 192. The sum is a minimum. So we did step one. Step two, take one of the equations and plug it into the other. Well, which one? Which equation do you want to optimize? Do we want to optimize the product one or do we want to optimize the sum? Well, let's look for the key word. We want to optimize one that says max or min. So we want to optimize this one. So this is the equation we want to take the derivative of. Well, how many variables do we have? We've got three. We can't do that. We can only take a derivative when there's two variables. Somebody in here has got to go away. This is where you get to choose. We're going to use our first equation and plug it into the other. It doesn't really matter which one we solve for. If we solve for x and plug it in, or we solve for y and plug it in, it doesn't really matter. So step one, we're going to take this equation and we're going to plug it in. I'm going to solve for x. So x equals 192 over y. I'm going to take it and I'm going to plug it in for the x value in the second equation. So what I have is 192 over y plus y equals m. So I got my two equations. I plugged one of the equations into the other. Why did I do that? Because I wanted to minimize this one and had too many variables. So I had to kind of consolidate and only get two variables left. So we said plug one equation into the other and we're going to simplify it. Well, let's clean it up a little bit. What we have is m equals 192 y to the negative 1 plus y. I just brought this y up because it's a monomial. I can do that quickly rather than having to use a quotient rule because I know what's about to happen. I want to take the derivative of this new equation. So again, step one is what you see in blue and purple. Step two is what we're seeing that we did in black. We took one equation and plugged it into the other. Step three, let's take a derivative. So if we take a derivative, what two variables do we see in this problem? We see m and we see y. So the derivative of m is 1, and we say dm dy. Because those, if you're telling the reader what other variable is in the problem, m is dependent upon y. If I had solved for y and plugged it in with x, we'd have m dx. But we're doing it with respect to y. So we took the derivative of m implicitly, and then it's dm dy. Here, we're going to take the derivative over here. What we see is we've got negative 192, y to the negative 2, and we can actually say dy dy, because you're taking the derivative of y with respect to itself. We tend not to do it. We tend just to skip it and say, well, that equals 1, so why would I write it? But we can if we want to. And then plus y, or plus the derivative of y, which is 1. And again, this is dy dy. So we just tend to skip that step and only write what the derivative actually is. So what we have is that dm dy equals negative 192 y to the negative 2 and everything else on plus 1. Well, that's a great derivative. Now that we've done it, we've taken a derivative and we're going to set it equal to 0 and solve. I wonder why we would set it equal to 0. Why would we take a derivative and set it equal to 0? Because we're trying to find a maximum or minimum. And that means we're taking a derivative and set it equal to 0. So now that we've got our derivative, let's set it equal to 0. So that means what we have is, again, we had these two equations, x times y equals 192, and we had x plus y equals some m. We found that we had 192 over y plus y equaled m. So here's step one. Step two, we solved our equation and we simplified. Step three, we got our derivative, that dm dy equals negative 192 y to the negative second power plus 1. So again, step one, we had our two equations. Step two, we plugged one into the other. And then step three, we took a derivative. We still need to finish step three. It says take a derivative and set it equal to 0. So that means I'm going to take this guy and I'm going to rewrite it so it's negative 192 over y squared plus 1 and set it equal to 0. I'm just bringing it down so I can solve. Now, I need to solve this equation for y. Well, the first thing I'm going to do is I'm just going to get this guy over to the other side and then I can cross multiply pretty quickly. What I get is negative 192 over y squared equals negative 1. I can cross multiply and I get negative 192 equals negative y squared, which means the two negatives are going to cross out, and I get y equals plus or minus the square root of 192. Now, it says that I'm looking for the product is 192 and the sum is a minimum. both of them are both a possible choice. If the question had said two positive numbers, well, we know that that's impossible for it to be the negative square root of it. But it doesn't specify if it's supposed to be positive or negative, so we're going to keep both. Which means if y equaled a positive square root of 192, then x equaled 192 over the square root of 192 if we solved correctly and plugged it back in to our equation. If y equaled negative square root of 192, then x equals 192 over negative square root of 192. This is the answer to our problem. What we did is we found an x value and a y value where, if we multiplied them together, we would get 192. And that if we add them, we would get a minimum value. So, how did we do it? We found two equations. We plugged one into the other. We simplified it. We set it equal to zero. Or excuse me, we took a derivative and then we set it equal to zero. Why do we take a derivative and set it equal to zero? Because we're finding maximums and minimums, optimization. And that's how we do to find critical numbers. And those critical numbers always yield for us maximum or minimum values. So now that we've got a question like this kind of under our belt, let's look at questions that deal with more applicable real world examples. But we're going to start off small. Okay, so here's a classic question that kind of pops up a lot. It says, a dairy farmer plans to fence in a rectangular pasture adjacent to a river. Adjacent means touching, next to. So we're going to put a pasture right next to a river. The river is going to produce water, which is going to just go into the soil, and all the grass is going to grow, and the herd's going to be so happy. So the pasture must contain 180 square meters in order to provide enough grass for the herd. What dimension would require the least amount of fencing if no fencing is needed along the river? So what we're seeing is the word least indicates to us, oh my goodness, I think that's a minimum. So again, the word least is triggering, that looks like a minimum value to me. I think this is optimization. I think I need to find two equations. So the first equation, well, before we do, let's figure out what the picture looks like. What we have is we have this river, and it's flowing nicely, and we want to put in a rectangular, basically, pasture. But we don't need fencing along the riverbank. We're going to assume that the cows are not going to jump into the river and float away. We're going to assume they're going to stay happy where they are on the grass. Now, we have to figure out, from here, we have this rectangular pasture, but we don't need anything along the riverbank because it says nothing is needed along the river. And it needs to contain 180 square meters. Square meters. Square means area. So they're saying that area is going to equal 180,000. Well, area. Area is base times height. So we can use X and Y. We can use B and H. Doesn't really matter if we use B and H, because we used X and Y last time. Here's B and here's H. We know that area is going to be the base times the height. So we know that the area is going to be 180,000 square meters. Then it says, what would the dimensions be to require the least amount of fencing? Fencing is the perimeter. So the amount of fencing we're talking about is the perimeter here. The perimeter, or the amount of fencing, would be I need two B's and one H. So two B's plus one H. Well, I have my two equations. Now I need to figure out which equation is the one I want to optimize. It's the perimeter. I want to get the least amount of fencing. I don't want to have to overbuy all this wood to put in for the pasture. I want to buy just the right amount to get exactly what I need. So I want to optimize this equation. Well, I've got three variables. I can't have that. I need to solve the first equation and plug it into the other. It doesn't really matter which one we do. So if we want to solve for B, we can do that. If we want to solve for H, we can do that. Let's solve for B. Why not? If we take this equation and say B equals 180,000 all over H, we're going to take this and we're going to plug it in. So now, again, I could have solved for H. It doesn't really matter. So the perimeter equals 2 times 180,000 all over H plus H. Well, if I multiply, I get 36,000. So I've got 360,000. H to the negative 1 plus H. So all I did here was I simplified just a little bit. Again, if you don't want to and you want to keep it as 2 times 180,000, by all means, go ahead and do that. It's not going to stop anybody. So all I did was move the monomial up so I can easily take a derivative. Because again, found my two equations, plugged one into the other. I simplified, so now I'm ready to take a derivative and set it equal to 0. Here we're taking the derivative of p with respect to h. So what we're seeing is dp dh equals, we'll take the derivative, we get negative 360,000, h to the negative 2, and then plus 1. What we're going to do now is we're going to take this guy and we're going to set it equal to 0 because I'm trying to find the least amount of fencing. I'm looking for a minimum. Derivative set equal to 0. So what I'm going to do first is I'm going to say this is actually negative 360,000 all over h squared plus 1 equals 0. So I'm simplifying that. I'm going to bring this guy over. So I have negative 360,000 all over h squared equals negative 1. Once I do that, I can now cross multiply. So if I cross multiply and I bring myself back up over here, I have negative 360,000 equals negative h squared. Well, the two negatives go away and I can take the square root. H equals plus or minus the square root of 360,000. But we also recognize that h is a distance, can't be negative. So we're going to say h is just the square root of 360,000. If you want to simplify and you got a calculator, go for it. If you don't know what it is, why worry? What we're going to find out is actually 600. So h is 600. If h is 600, well then, what's b? Well, we know that b was 180,000 all over h. So then we can just plug that in. So b is 180,000 all over 600. And now I know what b has to be. So what I'm seeing is that all I gotta do is pull out my two equations, plug one into the other, take a derivative, set it equal to 0, and solve it. That's it for optimization. So now let's look. We look at the dairy farmer. Let's look at a rancher.